Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to the summary of episode 46, where I was with Brian Clark, a Microsoft Cloud Advocate, to talk about the best extension to work with Visual Studio Code and Azure. There's so much great extension in Visual Studio Code to work with Azure that it's the second episode. If you want to watch the first one, the link will be in the description down below. Like I mentioned, we will cover the best extension to work with Azure, but also we will talk about the Microsoft Learn module that cover the same topic. Excellent, right? But before we go into the root, let's learn more about Brian.
You are a Microsoft employee. You are a cloud advocate, right? Just like me. But you are focusing on which area? Like, what's your focus?
Team that focuses on academics. So the academic audience. How can we, as cloud advocates, help folks in that community, in the academic community, both faculty and students that are in college, high school, you know, varying levels of stages of education? How can we help engage with them, find out what are the things that they need for their development purposes and the courses that they might be going through and the curriculum they have? That's the team I'm on that's focused on that kind of stuff. So
when did you know that you want to work in IT or be a developer or something like that?
That's an interesting question too. Thank you for all that. You got all these thought-provoking questions that I'm not ready to answer.
That's but I don't share the question before people.
No. It's not. Yeah, it's not like that. So when I was younger, even now, I'm an avid gamer, and I really enjoyed playing video games when I was younger. Spent a lot of time on it, and I was really into the Halo series, and so much so that I like was following the development company Bungie at that point in time, and so at that moment when I was doing that, I was like, I knew I loved working or being, learning things on the computer. The same time frame that this was all going on, we had like a Packard Bell computer, and I was just learning everything and like how to fix things, how to tinker. I just enjoy tinkering and like breaking things open and seeing how things work inside of them. And so I knew I liked that about computers, but I also liked gaming. So I was thinking, maybe I'll get into game development. And as I was following along with Bungie, I realized that a lot of them, there was this recurring theme that they felt, this pressure, some of them would kind of describe their work-life balance was not very good. Like they would spend days at the office in crunch time leading up to the release date of a game coming out. And I was like, at a young age, I knew, I was like, I don't want that. Like, as much as I think this is cool and I'd want to be into it, I was like, I don't want to go that route. So then I was like, okay, I know I wanted to do stuff with computers. And so I knew like at a fairly early age, I would say. So probably around like 16 is when I knew I wanted to do something with computers.
Wow, okay.
And then when it came to college, I didn't know what I wanted to specialize in terms of like around computers. So I went and studied, I went for a degree in computer engineering, because that to me felt like, based on the curriculum that I saw schools were posting about, it'd be like partly hardware, partly software. And it turns out though that my schooling leaned very heavily on the hardware side of the studies and less on the software side of things. And I got more of the software education via hands-on, on-the-job kind of training things via internships and whatnot, not on my own.
I can tell you, it was a lot of fun recording that episode. But now, let's learn more about the best extension to work with Azure, starting by Azure Storage.
That'll bring up this new Explorer, kind of like the File Explorer view, but there's these different collapsible sections. In the past, we looked at database, app services, and functions, but now that I have the Azure Storage extension installed, it just gets added as another section as part of this view. And so this allows me to explore any resources or instances of Azure Storage that I have set up, which I'm not sure. I don't work with Azure Storage that much with the stuff.
You work with Azure Storage, you just don't know it.
That's the thing, right? That's what I'm kind of.
Azure Storage is everywhere. It's the resources across the board. It's everywhere.
Yeah. And I've kind of realized that a little bit. Being that we brought it up and we're talking about it, I want to check out the Azure Static Web Apps extension, which is now installed. Let's see how, let's say you installed it. we're going through this experience together, folks in chat and viewers watching this maybe later on. We're going to go through, I have not run through this extension before, so we're going to read the README. When you have an extension, you click on it, you look at the README that's built into it here, and use this extension to quickly create and manage Azure Static web apps preview directly from VS Code. So let's see if we can do that. Should we try doing that, Frank, or what do you think?
Yeah, sure.
Am I diverging from the plan a little bit too much? No? Okay.
Yeah, just go for it. Okay.
All right, I'm going for it. Create your first static web app. Click the plus button in the Explorer to set up a new static web app. Okay, where is it under, though? Right here. Let's create a new one. The extension Azure Static Web Apps wants to sign in using GitHub.
Where are
you? Okay, so now now it's kind of hard to see based on the theme I'm using, but in the top center of the screen, there's a prompt that says create static web app. Step 1 of 8, I need to enter a new name. I don't know why I was talking like that. A name for the new static web app. What shall we call it, folks in chat? Static McStatic app. Okay.
Static McStatic app. Wow.
Static McStatic app. In camel case. Thank you, Bald Bearded Builder in the chat. We're going with that. I hit enter. What organization? This is based on my GitHub organization, so I'm going to go with the Clarkio one. Need to choose a repository. What if I don't have one? Create a new. Oh, there we go. Answered. New GitHub repository. What do we call it again? Static mix static app. Enter. Enter the location of the application code. For example, okay, we'll go with the default. Azure Functions code API. Okay, we'll go with the default. We'll go with the default.
So with that in that file, what you could write now is you have IntelliSense with the CLI. So that's pretty cool. So right from the bat, when you're just typing AZ and then your tab, you will have all the option of what you want. So you could right away do that if you want. And also what I really like about that is when you are in your script, you just do control and then tick or apostrophe. And it will take the current line or the current selection and automatically paste it in your terminal. So there's no more copy paste. You just do it. It takes the whatever line you are and move it over there. And if you do it with shift, then it take the result and put it in another tab of Visual Studio Code. So like, for example, you're running a query. You say, oh, give me all the resource group that contain a VM that is disabled or something like that. And like you have a lot of VMs or a lot of containers and like you want all the result. So you could format the result and have it open another tab. So like then you could search more in detail. So it's really useful when you're like back and forward in a script or trying to debug a script or write a long deployment script. That tool is very cool for that.
Microsoft Learn is a fantastic platform to learn about many different topics. And there's one specifically for Visual Studio Code. So by having Brian on the show, it was the best time to look to this specific module. Have a look.
Like show what it is, what kind of feedback. And like one thing that I really like, and you just brought that, Clark, Brian, is that you know the time. So that's what I like about it, because sometime you could say, oh, well, I want to learn about how to deploy. We spent a lot of time talking about static web app. Well, there's a module that explain how to do that from Visual Studio Code also, because, you know, I picked that one because it was really an introduction, but there's plenty of other module with Visual Studio Code. So it's pretty cool because most of the time, except this one is really like how to install the tool, though they don't give you a context. But because I already did it, I don't have the start button, but usually you have a start button and you just jump from page to page like a wizard thing where you pass through all this stuff. So here it gives you like why would you like to open, like what it is, Visual Studio Code. It's an open source. A thing about Visual Studio Code that we don't think enough now, they explain to you like, okay, where to go to install it. So of course you go to code.visualstudio.com. Let's put that in the chat just to make it easier for you. If you don't have it, you could start right away to install it if you want. And then, like, it just show you what kind of install it is. It is very simple. One thing I would add, and I don't know if Brian, you agree to that, but I would strongly check those two things. It's so nice when are in Windows, like a file explorer, you could open the file in Visual Studio Code, or you could open the full folder in Visual Studio Code. I would suggest to check all of those, but maybe you'd like another code editor or text editor. Then they explain our focus of today was extension for Azure, or like that are good with Azure, but there's tons of a really amazing extension like Python. I had Nina coming on the show, and she said that the extension with Python made Visual Studio kind of the best place to do Python, apparently. I don't know Python. You know Python, Brian, right? So,
yeah.
I'm assuming with Cecile, right? When you do that on your stream?
Yeah, right on this channel. Yeah, Wednesdays.
On Wednesday. Eastern.
There's so much to cover. If you're interested to see the longer version of the interview, the Visual Studio extension, or the Learn module, all the links will be in the description. I'm looking forward to see you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.